Hey guys, Eli Plays Arma here. A few people have been asking me to make a tutorial on how I fly the Blackfish, so I thought I'd do that for you. Okay guys, so I've loaded up a video where I am going to talk to you about the basics. Well, basically, up here in the corner, you got everything you need to fly this thing. You got your speed, your altitude, your throttle input, and it's also going to tell you when your gear is out or if you got this thing, which normally in a helicopter, this tells you when auto hover is on. In a Blackfish, it's going to tell you when your auto vectoring is off. And to fly like I do, you need to turn your auto vectoring off. That enables you to decrease and increase vectoring, aka pitch the engines up and down. You do this by scrolling standard in Arma, but you can bind a key to it. It's the flaps up and flaps down key. So if you want to be able to do it quicker, you can just bind a key to it and you can use that. Anyways, you're going to see me approach here on a LZ. It's just a spawn and a king of the hill. I am 1500 meters out now and going around 400. At around 1,000 meters away from my LZ, you're going to see me pitch my engines back to completely back, so it's in helicopter mode. I'm still going to keep my throttle input at 100. Very important. Always keep your throttle input at 100 when you're going in to do a landing like this. At around 5 to 400 meters, you're going to see me pull the aircraft back to get it to do that 90 degree angle stopping flare, I guess you can say. Now, I might, at the end of that flare, pull the engines forward one click or maybe two clicks, still keeping the throttle at 100%, just to make it pull itself back from that angle. Because sometimes when you come in at a steep angle like that, you're not going to be able to pull it back fast enough. So I'm just gonna play the clip, and you can see me pull the engines back around now, and then do a little flare down and pull it back. In this particular case, I didn't have to pull the engines forward to pull it back up. I was fast enough to pull it back up. Now, it's not always going to go down like that, but there's a fine line between when you can pull the aircraft back without using your engine power to do it, like using the flipping the engines forward again and pulling it back up. If you do it for a short time and you feel like your speed has come down enough and you're going slow enough, you can pull it back without powering it back, so to speak. You can see that I've started dropping my engine power now because I'm hovering to go in for the landing. I'm gonna mute this because that's a lot of music. Anyways, so I'm gonna go over it again. At around 1,000 meters here, you see me start pulling my engines up. I make a little dip down. I do this because I want the altitude as low as possible for the flare, because you don't want to be high up in a King of the Hill mode. It's going to take you a long time to come back down to the ground, and that's going to open you up for rockets or anything. You've got to keep in mind this is a big target. But you see me banking left. I prefer banking left. You can bank left, right. You can even just bank up. But I like banking left. You can see me using my rudder to pull it into that position. And now I'm going away from the LZ. So you see me pull my rudder back to the right to kind of get the angle to go down next to the LZ. So it's, I'm gonna do that, and yes, I did get too close here. You can see it's really close. So in this frame, you will see that I'm completely in helicopter mode. The engines are completely pulled back, but I've realized that I'm too close to the ground. So in the next frame here, you can see that I've clicked the engines forward one click to pull the aircraft back up a little bit. This helps a lot, tremendously actually. You have to get a feel for when you need to pitch your engines forward again if you're in a position where it's unrecoverable. So you can see that after I've done this, I gain a lot of altitude again. And in this situation, you need to be quick to pull the engine back up or pull the engines back into helicopter mode. Sometimes it helps to, in this, when you come out of this this spot, you can drop your engine speed a little bit, but then you need to be quick to pull it back up when you feel like you're going down again. So I'm going to play this clip again and just watch what I do. So I come in, pull the engines up, I flare, I pull them back forward again and pull them back towards, well, helicopter mode, and I touch it down. It's very simple, the basics of it. It's not hard to do this maneuver. It just takes practice. So I'm going to go through with you. Just pull up the, on the screen, I'm going to pull up the basics that you need. I'm just going to make a list of what to think about, and then I'm going to show you a couple of clips and just observe what I do. And when you feel like you're ready to try it out yourself, just load up ARM and try it. That's how easy it is.
Problems are not the only one. When the sugar left you on the run. So mo my mum. Take a look now at what your boy has done. He's walking around like he's number one. So he went downtown and he got all my guns. Don't shoot that thing at me. Don't shoot that thing at me. You know you got my sympathy, but don't shoot that thing at me. Don't shoot that thing at me.
Top floor of the top level of Tower Floor. Leave the sinking ship behind. Come on the rising wind. I think you're on 5, because I'm on 4 and a half. Bring a song and a smile for the banjo.
Better get wild and get good. Hit your ride to the... Are you learning on the tower again?
No, and there's too many friendlies in there now. We'll land somewhere else.
Okay.
Okay,
from the ground.
Yeah, yeah, dude.
That's fucked up. Oh, man.
Someone's too big.
That when you slow down like that, that is fucking mean as fuck. I don't want to go, baby. New York to East LA. Oh, my God, fuck it all.
Was the far right side, one on the ground.